In this video, we will explore the group block. Think of the group block as a container for putting other blocks together. It helps you to organize content and also apply styles to multiple elements simultaneously. You can use the group block to organize related content and create reusable sections such as testimonials or services. The group block also allows you to add a background color or even an image to a section. Let's make our way to Appearance and then click Editor. This is where you can customize the appearance of your website using the block editor. Then we can go ahead and open our homepage and then open the list view, which helps you to see which blocks are nested inside others. You may encounter several layers of nested group blocks. Nesting just means blocks inside other blocks. To add a group block, click on the plus icon top left and then search for group. But we are going to use the shortcut and type /, and the name of the block, in this case, group, and then insert the block. When you select the group block, you will have four different options: group, row, stack, and grid. These are special variations of the group block that control how blocks inside are arranged. Row arranges blocks side by side or horizontally. Stack arranges them vertically like a column, and grid lets you arrange content in rows and columns. In this video, we will focus on the main group block that arranges blocks in a container. So let's go ahead and add the main group block and open the list view. Once added, you can start filling it with content and selecting the blocks individually. Another option is to use the list view to group individual blocks. Hold in Shift on your keyboard and select all the blocks you want to group. And then in the block toolbar, you can click on the three vertical dots and select Group. Or you can just click on the group block icon on the left of your block toolbar. And then you will notice that all these blocks are now nested within the group block. Next, let's discuss inner blocks use content width. When you add a group block and nest other blocks within it, and then open your sidebar settings on the right, you will notice that inner blocks use content width is enabled by default. But you might be wondering, what does that mean? It means blocks inside a group inherit the width defined by your theme. So even if you change the alignment of the group block to wide width, or for example, full width, the blocks don't change. The inner blocks remain at a standard width. But if you deselect inner blocks use content width, the inner blocks will expand to the width set. Next, let's look at how you can use the group block to create a structured and clean layout. Let's add a group block by typing /, group, and then inserting the block. And then we will select the main container block, followed by inserting a columns block and selecting two equal columns. We will place a heading in the left column, name it Ramen, and add some text in the right column. Then select the columns block in the list view, click the three vertical dots and choose Add After to insert a gallery block below the columns block. And in this example, I will select three images from my media library, and then create a new gallery. Now, let's style the group block to give the section a more polished look. First, I will select the main group block in the list view. And seeing that I want to change the group's alignment, I will first deselect inner blocks use content width, and then in the block toolbar, change the alignment to wide width. Next, we can go to styles and change the background color of the group block, followed by adding some horizontal and vertical padding around the content in the block. Let me also share a few helpful tips. You can use multiple group blocks to organize pages with lots of content more effectively. You can also rename your group blocks to keep things clear, especially when working in the list view. To do this, click the three vertical dots next to the block name in the list view, select Rename, and enter a descriptive name, such as intro, testimonial, team, or as in the second example, services. This makes it easier to identify each section at a glance, and you can rename other blocks as well. You can also reorder group blocks by using the mover arrows in the block toolbar, or by dragging and dropping the group to a new position in the list view. It's also a good idea to avoid over-nesting blocks, as too many layers can make your layout harder to manage and edit. Keeping your block structure simple makes it easier for you to make changes. If your layout feels cluttered, check for group blocks that are either empty or contain only a single block. These are usually unnecessary. Also, remember that the columns block is already a container, so in this case, it doesn't have to be wrapped in two group blocks. To simplify things, click the three vertical dots and then select Ungroup to remove unnecessary layers. Secondly, you can also lock the group block to prevent accidental changes from happening when editing a page. This is especially useful when you're working on a site for a client and want to protect certain design elements. By locking key sections, you can ensure that they stay in place even if the client edits the page. To do this, click the three vertical dots in the toolbar, select Lock, and choose whether to prevent the block from being moved, deleted, or both. And you can also choose to apply the lock to all the blocks inside the group block. Now you will see a lock next to each block, and when you click on the three vertical dots, you will not see the option to delete. And in the block toolbar, there's no option to move it to a new location. But remember, you can unlock it at any time if adjustments are needed. Lastly, always check how your design appears on mobile. So, to preview your layout on a smaller device, click on the laptop icon top right, and then select tablet, or in this case, mobile. Always ensure that your design translates well to smaller screens. And that's it for this lesson on using the group block. I hope it gave you a clearer understanding of how it works and how you can use it to build more flexible and organized layouts.